إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد The shaitan, al-mal'oon, the cursed, takes many forms, he takes many shapes, and he takes many subul, he takes many ways and many plans and anything he can do to misguide mankind. If you can misguide him completely, misguide him totally, or misguide him even a little bit, he is haris, he is very anxious, and he is very, very motivated for the misguidance of you and me. For the misguidance of you and I. He wants misguidance for us. He wants us to go to Jahannam. He doesn't want to be there alone. He wants some company. So he will do anything and whatever he can in his power to misguide you. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, يَا بَنِي آدَمْ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ أَلَمْ أَعْهَدَ إِلَكَ يَا بَنِي آدَمْ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُ الشَّيْطَانِ Did I not take a covenant with you, O children of Adam, that you don't worship shaytan, the shaytan, meaning don't obey the shaytan? إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوبٌ مُبِينٌ Indeed, he is for you a clear and open enemy. He's not hiding it. He's a clear and open enemy to mankind. And to the Muslims, and specifically, especially the Muslims. Because we have already bared witness to the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whereas the rest of mankind still has to take that step. So he wants to misguide you. And by misguiding you, he'll misguide the other people. Because if there's nobody else left on the earth to call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he's done his job. So it's upon us as Muslims to know what are the ways that the shaytan, he attacks mankind? How does he attack us in specific? How does he misguide us? What roads and ways does he take? What avenues does he adapt so that he can misguide you and I? And there are many. The shaytan is an old enemy. He's older than us. Rather, as many of the ulama point out, like Adam alayhi salam was our father, he is the father of humanity. Likewise, the shaytan, Iblis, is the father of the jinn. He's the oldest of them. He's been around for a long time. And if you think he's stupid, and you think he's impatient, and you think that you could trick him into, you can't. The only way to protect yourself from the shaytan is to turn to the one who created the shaytan, who created Adam and his children, the one who in his hand is Al-Kawn, the entire world, Khair and Shar, good and bad. But it is a benefit to know what the shaitan does, how he misguides humanity. I'm going to only go over three. And like I said, there's many, many, many ways that the shaitan comes to us. But inshallah ta'ala, today we'll only talk about three. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر. Number one. الشيطان يعدكم الفقر. Fakr. He wants you to He promises you and he threatens you with faqr, with poverty. This is sabil number one. And I begin with this because we live in a world where material wealth is the only way we judge our success. Look at the house he has, look at the car he has, look at the husband or the wife he or she has, look how many children does he have, what are his children wearing, what is he wearing, what school did his children go, what school did he go to, how many degrees does he have, what kind of degrees does he have, blah, 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 on and on and on and on. Inna shaytan, ya'idukum al-faqr. The shaytan, he threatens you and he promises you what? Faqr. Poverty. Don't give up from what you have. Look how little you have in the first place. Don't give up from what you have. Right? Hoard up your wealth. He scares you with your dunya. That's the first thing he does. Don't leave off the bank system. Don't leave off your mortgage. You're going to have no home. Where are you going to live? What about your children? What about your wife? What are you going to put in their stomachs? Don't leave off riba. Gambling. Oh, take the chance. What if you win the $1 million? It's only haram if you spend it on yourself. Right? Don't spend it on your family. Spend it on somebody else. Give it to the masjid. Right? So shaitan, he'll come to you and he'll scare you with your dunya. And this is the nature of mankind. We're afraid for our material wealth, for our material pleasure. Right? الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالسوء. And he orders you with evil and lewd behavior. But you know what? He's not going to be able to come to you and be like, do evil. Do shirk. Do bid'ah. Lie. Steal. Cheat. No. He has to make a premises, which is fear of poverty. That's why Allah says, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالسوء. He doesn't say وَيَأْمَرُكُمْ بِالسُّوءِ only. No, he needs to bring a premises. So your premises is anxiety. The anxiety of poverty. Because like Allah says in the Qur'an, Ibn Hazm, rahimahullah, who is an Andalusian scholar, he mentioned that the entire life of a mankind, all his actions could be reduced to one sentence. And that sentence is طَرْضُ الْهَمْ. طَرْضُ الْهَمْ, meaning to ward off anxiety. That's the entire, all the actions of mankind can be reduced down to that. You eat, why? Because you fear hunger. You wear clothes, why? Because it's cold outside and we fear our nakedness. We work, why? Because we need the money so they could feed our stomachs. We sleep, why? Because we're afraid of being tired and all of these things. Everything we do is reduced down to that. طَرْضُ الْهَمْ. Warding off anxiety in our life. And how does the most effective way of bringing anxiety into our lives that the shaitan uses is يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ. He threatens you with poverty. Don't do that, you'll become poor. Don't give to the masjid, you'll become poor. Don't leave off riba, you'll become poor. What are other people going to think of you? You have to go, you have to do that haram thing, you need that degree, you need that PhD. What are you going to do if you don't get it? You're going to become poor. Like Allah says in the Quran, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ هَلُوعًا. هَلُوعًا. What is هَلَعًا? The insan was created هَلُوعًا. I'll explain to you in a state of anxiety. But the good way to explain to you what that means, what Allah SWT means here, is like when a child is born.